Here's another example of a method of moments estimator. A MOM estimator for P, one of the parameters in a binomial distribution. I'll write it this way. Parameter from BNP, binomial distribution in general has two parameters. Think of the N as fixed. Think of the N as fixed or given. And you're interested in estimating P, the probability of success, like for free throws. You actually already thought about this on the homework due today, though you didn't realize it, what I'm about to show you. We know from chapter 3 that the expected value of a binomial random variable with parameters n and p is n times p. We know that. It's chapter 3. This is mu. This formula only works for binomial random variables. Right? You can't use this formula for other random variables. The method of moments, MOM, says replace the mean, the first moment, with its natural estimator, x bar. N is fixed, so still call it an N. And replace the parameter you're trying to find an estimator for with a symbol for its estimator, p hat. By the way, we could also call x bar mu hat if we liked. Anytime you put a hat above a parameter, it's the standard symbol for an estimator of that parameter. Parameters are numbers. Estimators are statistics. They are different things. Then solve this equation for the estimator you want to find. Solve this for p hat. Divide both sides by n. The method of moments estimator for p is p hat equals x bar over n. But wait a minute. Does that mean if I simplify this formula, there would be two n's in it? Because x bar is the sum of the xi's over n, right? Well, if you were thinking about this kind of problem, you'd want to use a different letter for the sample size. How about an m instead of an n? So m is the sample size here. Not for your binomial random variable, but for the random sample, capital X1, capital X2 through capital Xm. I.e., our random sample is capital X1, capital X2 through capital Xm. Each of these variables has a binomial distribution with parameters N and P. Say N is 20. I'm shooting free throws. I'm attempting 20 free throws and P is 0.4. I got a 40% chance of success. Each of these numbers, their observed values would be between 0 and 20, most likely close to 8, right? N times P would be 20 times 0.4 is 8. But maybe I do this experiment 100 times. M would be 100. And I get 100 observed values that are all between 0 and 20, mostly close to 8. Their average would be close to 8. If I divide that by 20, I'll get a number close to 0.4. Right? 8 divided by 20 would be 0.4. I get an observed value of p hat. So when you're thinking about a binomial distribution with parameters n and p, you want a different letter for the sample size of the random sample, like m. This formula could be simplified. You could write it like this. If you wanted to. Is p hat found with the method of moments unbiased? You thought about this kind of thing for your homework as well. What's the expected value of p hat? Here I can use properties of expectation because the x bar is in the numerator, not the denominator like the last example. I can pull out the 1 over n. And I know the expected value of x bar is the mean of the population, because x bar is unbiased. And I know the mean of the population for a binomial random variable is n times p. The n cancels, and you're left with a p. So yes, the expected value of p hat is p. Therefore, p hat is unbiased. It's an unbiased estimator for p.